Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today I wanted to share a braided hairstyle with you. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. If you're new, please subscribe, then you'll never miss any future videos. And let's get started. For the first part of this hairstyle, I'm going to be creating two French braids on both sides of my head. With my hair parted near the center, I'm going to divide off a section of hair on the left side and divide it into three smaller pieces for my braid. Since I'm creating a French braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the two side sections. After the first stitch of the braid, I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. So I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over into the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the other side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over, bringing it into the middle strand as well. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, crossing the side strands over the middle strand while adding in additional sections of hair to create the French braid style along the left side of my head. On the bottom side of the braid, I'm bringing in hair from along the hairline. And to the top side of the braid, I'm bringing in hair from along the part line. So I'm just crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over, bringing it into the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the other side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the braid, crossing it into the middle strand. And once the braid reaches my left ear, I'm going to stop adding in hair on this side of the braid because I want the braid to curve around towards the back of my head, and this helps it lay a little bit more smoothly. So I'm just going to continue bringing in hair to the top side of the braid from along the top of my head. And then when the braid reaches the back of my head, I'm going to continue braiding the section a little further down without adding in any additional pieces. And then once the braid reaches near the bottom, I'm going to take a bobby pin and slide it over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now that one braid is done, I'm going to repeat the same steps and create a second French braid with the hair on the right side of my head. I'm going to divide off a section of hair next to the part and divide it into three smaller pieces. Again, I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the two side strands to begin the French braid. So I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over and bringing it into the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the other side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over, bringing it into the middle strand as well. I'm going to repeat this pattern, crossing the side strands over the middle strand while adding in additional sections of hair to create a French braid along the right side of my head. On the bottom side of the braid, again, I'm bringing in hair from along the hairline. And to the top side of the braid, I'm bringing in hair from along the part line and the crown of my head. Then, once the braid reaches my right ear, I'm going to stop adding in hair to the bottom side of the braid, and I'm only going to bring in hair to the top side of the braid from the top of my head. And when the braid reaches the back of my head or meets the other braid, I'm going to continue braiding the section a little further down, and then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid so that I can work with it later. Next, I'm going to divide off two sections of hair from under the braids, and I'm going to combine them together over the rest of the hair. Using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie the hair together. And then I'm going to flip the ends up and around the elastic, and this will make the two sections twisted on the sides. Now with the remaining hair, I'm going to create a fishtail braid. So I'm splitting the remaining hair into two sections, a left side and a right side. I'm going to be dividing off sections of hair from one side and crossing it over, adding it into the opposite side. So I'm taking a smaller section from the left side, crossing it over and adding it into the right section of hair. Then I'm going to divide off a section from the right side, cross it over the top and add it into the section on the left side,
So I always only have two main sections of hair, and I'm going to continue this pattern, repeating these steps with the remaining hair until the braid reaches down near the bottom. So I'm dividing off small sections of hair from both the left and the right sections, crossing each one over the top, adding them into the opposite side, and I'm alternating between the left side and the right side, creating a fishtail style braid with the hair. You can cross over smaller sections or larger sections, or kind of alternate the size of the sections to create a little bit more interest with the braid. But I'm just repeating those steps, working my way down the section of hair until the braid reaches far enough down the section. And then I'm going to take a clear elastic band and tie this over the end of the braid so that it doesn't unravel. Then I'm going to go back over the sides of the braid and carefully pull small pieces up and out of the elastic so they slide out just slightly. And I'm going to work my way all the way up the braid from the bottom to the top, pulling out the left and the right sides. This will make the braid look a lot wider, so it'll look a little more casual and lived in. You can keep it tight and small if you prefer. Just depends on the type of style that you want to go for. I think this is a really fun style to wear during the summer. It has kind of a boho type of vibe. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. If you're new, make sure to subscribe, click that notification bell as well, then you'll never miss any future videos. And I will see you next time.